In the last video, we found the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a symmetric matrix. Symmetric matrices are very nice because they have real eigenvalues, and you can always find linearly independent eigenvectors. In this video, I'm going to show you the not so nice cases, the case where you have a matrix may have fewer eigenvectors than its dimension. So an n by n matrix may not have n linearly independent eigenvectors. And also a matrix that is not symmetric may have complex eigenvalues. So I'll show you that case also. But it turns out that actually the symmetric matrix case is the most important case. So that one, it's very nice and and we'll work on that type of matrix later in later videos. So that's the most important case. So let's work through these exceptional cases. The first matrix I want to work is this simple 2x2 matrix, 0, 1, 0, 0. So remember, we're doing Bx equals lambda x, the eigenvalue problem. So b minus lambda I x equals 0. So the determinant is 0. So we have the determinant of b minus lambda I is subtract lambda from the diagonal. So minus lambda 1, 0, minus lambda. That's minus lambda times minus lambda is lambda squared minus 0 times 1 is 0, so that's just lambda squared. And the characteristic equation is the determinant of b minus lambda I equals 0. So here we have lambda squared equals 0. So there's only one eigenvalue. It's a repeated root of the characteristic equation, and that is lambda equals 0. We want to find the eigenvector. So b minus 0x equals 0. So we're looking for b times x equals 0. Okay, very simple. B times x equals 0 for the eigenvector. So we have the matrix then is simply 0, 1, 0, 0 times the eigenvector v1, v2 equals 0. The second row is not very interesting, 0 equals 0, right? The first row is 0 times v1 plus v2 equals 0. So that just tells us v2 is equal to 0. So we have our eigenvalue, lambda equals 0. And then our eigenvector associated with this eigenvalue, I'll call it x here because there's only one of them, has a second component equal to 0, so v2 equals 0. v1 can be anything because we can multiply by a free constant, so we just choose it to be 1. So here we have a single eigenvector, 1, 0. So when you multiply b by x, you get 0, okay? So this is an example of a 2x2 matrix that has only a single eigenvalue and a single eigenvector, okay? Finally, one more example. We can look at the matrix C equals 0, minus 1, 1, 0. This is a skew symmetric matrix. Remember, a skew symmetric matrix is the C transpose is equal to minus C. So this is skew symmetric. This does not have real eigenvalues. So we can determine the eigenvalues here. We have the determinant of C minus lambda I is going to be subtract minus lambda from the diagonal, minus lambda, minus 1, 1, minus lambda. And that's equal to lambda squared minus minus 1. So lambda squared plus 1 equals 0, okay? Determinant of C minus lambda I equals 0. Lambda squared plus 1 equals 0, or lambda squared equals negative 1, okay? So this is a number that when you square it, you get negative 1. That's the definition of the imaginary number. So I, remember, if you've seen this before, I is the square root of negative 1, right? That's called the imaginary number. And then minus I is just the negative of I. So this lambda squared equals minus 1 has two roots. So there are two eigenvalues. Lambda 1 equals plus I. And lambda 2 is equal to minus I. This matrix has complex eigenvalues. Complex eigenvalues are important when one considers problems, say, in differential equations where one has oscillations. Complex eigenvalues represent oscillating motion. So we'll have to learn about this later when we go into detail. When you study a differential equations course, you'll have to learn about the case of complex eigenvalues. But for the purpose of this course, we can stay with our real eigenvalues, so let me not go into further depth here. Okay, to summarize, you have matrices that are not as nice as in the last example. Symmetric matrices are very nice. You have real eigenvalues. You have n eigenvectors. The non-symmetric matrices, some of them are nice, but others may have problems, like this one has only one eigenvector. This one has complex eigenvalues. Okay, from now on, we'll talk about cases where we have real eigenvalues, and we'll have some fun learning about matrix diagonalization. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.